you have questions? Do you need answers? The Pastor Study will help you find those answers through God's Word. Our teacher today is Pastor Tom Brock. The Pastor Study is sponsored by PastorStudy.org. So grab your Bible and join us for The Pastor Study.
Welcome to the Pastor Study. Years ago, here's a young 14-year-old girl from my church. I taught her confirmation, and she loved the Lord. Her family loved the Lord. Then she gets into high school, gets a Mormon boyfriend. Her family's very concerned. The girl and her boyfriend come into my office. I sit down with them, and I said, "Now, Lori, Mormons believe in thousands of gods. Christians believe in one God. And Mormons believe that our God became God on another planet. No, we believe God has always been God." Well, I just shared with her that Mormonism is not Christianity. Sadly, to her parents' chagrin, she married the guy and now they're raising Mormon children in Utah. Here's another woman of our church. Didn't like it when I preached against sin because she thought that was negative energy. And then she started living with her boyfriend and immediately left our church for the Unity Church. And at the Unity Church, they don't talk about sin because everything is positive energy. Then the third person I think of is my mom. Now, my mom was raised Missouri Synod Lutheran. You don't get more conservative than Missouri Synod Lutheran. But before she died, she said, "Tommy, have you ever seen Sylvia on Montel?" I said, "Yeah, Mom, I have. She's a psychic. She talks to the dead. You can't do that. Bible says that's an abomination. That's a farce and it's evil." No, Tommy. She's a good Christian. She talks about God and angels." I said, "Mom, the angels she talks about aren't angels. They're probably demons." But, you know, and I thought, if my Missouri Synod Lutheran mom is getting deceived by this stuff, we need to do a couple shows on the cults. So this is part one. Next week will be part two. We're going to talk about the cults today. And let's pray, and then let's get into this. So let's just take a moment. Father, we do want to pray for anyone watching this program who has been caught up in some false teaching, that somehow you'll bring them out of the darkness and get them into a good Christian church. Lord, probably all of us have loved ones that have been messed up some way in the cults or liberal false Christianity. We pray your Holy Spirit would speak to us now about the truth. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, the cults. Let me give you the definition of a cult. Quote, "A cult is a group that claims to be Christian, but which denies basic Christian beliefs." Let me repeat that. A cult is a group that claims we're Christians too, but you look at their doctrines and they're not Christians. I mean, Judaism is not a cult because they don't claim to be Christians. Islam is not a cult because they don't claim to be Christians. Hinduism is not a cult, but a cult says, "Well, we're Christians too," but then you look at their doctrine and you know, "Oh no, you're not." So before we get into what the cults believe, we got to find out what the genuine item is first. What do genuine Christians believe? What are the basic teachings of the Christian church? All right, here are the basics, and these are where the cults will stray. Basic number one, the Bible is the final authority. If you're a Christian, the final authority to you is, what did Jesus teach? What did the apostles teach? What did God teach us in the Bible? Our final authority is not Mary Baker Eddy and her book, Health and Key to Science and Health. Our basic book is not the Book of Mormon. It's not the Watchtower magazine. If you're a Christian, your book is the New Testament and the Old Testament. Second basic of Christianity, God is the creator, but he's separate from his creation. God made the trees and the flowers. God is not the trees and the flowers. God, Jesus taught us to pray, "Our Father who art in heaven." In other words, God is separate from his creation. He is not to be identified. God is not the trees and the mountains. Next basic teaching of Christianity is man is sinful since the fall in the garden. We're sinners. Adam and Eve brought sin onto this planet. Cults tend to teach man is basically good. You just need to get in touch with your own divinity, your own inner godness. You're not a sinner. Let's not talk negatively. You are God, some of the cults teach. No. In Christianity, we believe in what's called original sin, that we all inherited sin because of Adam and Eve. And I like what the late William F. Buckley, the Catholic, used to say, the doctrine of original sin is the one teaching of the Christian church that is empirically verifiable. In other words, you can prove this one. All you need to do is read the newspaper. All you need to do is watch the evening news or just take a hard look in the mirror. Sin is everywhere. It's awfully hard to deny that. Next basic teaching of Christianity, God is the Trinity. Now, all the cults will play with the Trinity. Jehovah's Witnesses at your door will say, the word Trinity is not in the Bible. It's a doctrine of the devil. They're wrong. They're right. The word Trinity is not in the Bible. But you find the concept of the Trinity, get this, in the first paragraph of the Bible. God created, that's the Father. The Spirit of God was moving, that's the Holy Spirit. God said, let there be light. The speaking, the Word of God is Jesus, according to John chapter 1. You find the Trinity all over the Bible. If you don't want to call it the Trinity, okay, but you still got to believe in one God, three persons. Jehovah's Witnesses won't. Next bedrock teaching of the Christian faith is Jesus is the God-man. There's only been one incarnation. Incarnation means the enfleshment of God. There haven't been 50 incarnations. I remember once at a Denver airport, the Hare Krishna came up to me and was evangelizing me. And finally I stopped him. I said, I'm sorry, I don't believe what you're teaching. I'm a Christian. And he says, we believe Jesus is a son of God. I said, I know, I believe he's the son of God, period. And so, you know, some cults have no problem saying Jesus is God because isn't everybody? I'll say this about Oprah. I'm glad her show was off the air because Oprah said she was raised Baptist. She says on her TV show, I used to believe Jesus came to die for our sins. Now I understand Jesus came to get us in touch with our own Christ consciousness. In other words, according to Oprah, we are all the Christ. That's a cult. Christians believe there's been one incarnation and we ain't him. Next basic teaching of the Christian faith, salvation is by grace alone. We're saved not by what I do, but by the grace, the unearned mercy and favor of God alone. All other world religions and all of the cults are into salvation by good works. You save you by being reincarnated enough times so you come back and get rid of your bad karma so eventually you can be dissolved into nirvana. But or you go to knock on enough doors with the Jehovah's Witness and maybe you'll be saved. All other religions, all other cults are salvation by good works. Christianity says, nope, it's by grace alone. Another bedrock teaching of the Christian faith, salvation is through Christ alone. Jesus said this himself, John 14:6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but by me, period. For cults, Jesus is nice, and they'll talk about Jesus as being one of their gurus and one of their teachers, but he's not necessary. And tragically, some of our Christian churches are talking like that. I have a loved one who goes to this very liberal church. So I checked out this website of this congregational church. It says this on the website, Jesus is our path to the divine. Nevertheless, we do not negate other paths that other people have found to God that are just as valid for them. All roads lead to God, and this is a congregational church. Well, one more bedrock belief of the Christian church is there's a heaven and a hell. Jesus said so. Now, for cults, normally, there is no hell. Normally, in a cult, everybody ends up in heaven because, you know, we're all basically good and just there's all kinds of paths, so you'll make it. Jesus taught there's a heaven and a hell, and we all deserve hell. Jesus is the only one to get you out of hell. That is the basics of the Christian church. Let me just review them. If you're a Christian, you believe, number one, the Bible is your final authority. God is the creator. He's separate from creation. Mankind is sinful. God is the Trinity. Jesus is the one and only God-man, the incarnation. Salvation is by grace alone. Salvation is through Christ alone. And yes, there is a heaven and a hell. That is what a Christian believes. Now, let's get into the cults. I've grouped the cults that are like-minded together. Today we're going to talk about Christian Science, the Unity Church, the Theosophy Movement, Scientology, and the big one, the New Age Movement. Next week we'll talk about the Mormons, Jehovah's Witnesses, and the sneakiest cult of all, liberalism, because it's within the Christian church. That's for next week. But today let's talk about, first, the Christian Science Church. You've probably seen the Christian Science Monitor newspaper, Christian Science reading rooms downtown. What is the Christian Science Church? Here we go. In 1866, a woman by the name of Mary Baker Eddy out east suffered an injury after a fall. During her illness, she discovered what she calls healing principles. In 1875, she wrote these principles in her book, Science and Health with a Key to the Scriptures, and she claims God inspired her to write this book. In 1879, in Massachusetts, the first Church of Christ Scientists was founded. Mary Baker Eddy eventually died in 1910. Today, there are over 3 million Christian scientists on Earth. What do they teach? They teach that Mary Baker Eddy's Science and Health book is new revelation from God. Quote, in the year 1866, I, Mary Baker Eddy, discovered Christ Science. God has been graciously preparing me during many years for the reception of this final revelation. Now, did you catch that? The Bible is not the final revelation. You can add a book to it if you're Mary Baker Eddy. She gets the big one, the final revelation, her book on science and health. See, that's the way you spot a cult. Most cults will use the Bible. We're Christians too, but then they add a book to it, like the Book of Mormon or the Watchtower Magazine or Mary Baker Eddy's Science and Health. Another belief of Christian scientists, and this one is kind of strange, so try to follow this, material substance does not really exist. Matter does not exist. Your TV set, this pulpit, your hands, your finger, matter doesn't really exist. You only think it does. The only thing that really exists is God. Now that's good pantheism. Pantheism is the belief that everything is God and God is everything. That's kind of Buddhism, Hinduism. It's not Christianity. I heard someone say once, Christian Science is neither Christian nor scientific. The verse that blows away Christian Science is the first verse in the Bible. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Is there a material, physical universe? Of course there is. Another belief of Christian Science, sin does not really exist. You just think it does. But because God is everything and everything is God, and because God is good, then everything is good. Sin doesn't really exist. You think it does, but you need to be retrained by Christian Science. Mary Baker Eddy said, quote, Christ came to destroy the belief of sin. Christ came to earth to show you that sin doesn't really exist. Wait a minute, Mary Baker Eddy. why did Jesus die on the cross if sin doesn't exist? I mean, here's the verse against Christian Science. 1 John 1:8, if we say we have no sin, we are